It's only a week to Paddy's Day, with thousands of tourists descending on the island to celebrate. But where are the best value deals to be had for a quick staycation this spring?
Yes, well, whether your budget is 3 or 4 star or you're really splashing out for a 5-star treat, travel writer Tom Bratnock is here to tell us more. He's got the scoop on everything,
doesn't
he, Tom?
How are you, folks? Are you well?
Good morning to you. So there is an array of hotel offerings and accommodation all around the country, and it's under our nose, isn't it?
Under our nose and within our budget.
And within our budget, which is very important. So we're going to start in Westport with a 3-star
Exactly. offering. Yeah, so I think the media and newspapers, 3 stars, I think, often get a bit like left behind because they don't have the big PR companies and kind of the flashy spreads. So there's an Irish company called selecthotels.com, and they have a nice range of 3-star hotels, including the Wyatt in Westport. So prices for here start from 50 quid.
Wow.
They're room only rates, so 25 euros per person sharing. It's a lovely 3-star hotel in the heart of Westport, which is kind of a quintessential Irish town.
It's straight
off.
It's a beautiful part of the country.
Yeah,
really,
it's like the Quiet
is.
Man.
Yeah.
Great for traditional music, or if you're active, you can go on. They've got, you know, the Mayo Greenway, or take road trips around the Wild Atlantic Way and
Crowpatrick.
Crowpatrick, exactly. Good time of year to be climbing it. And so 55 euros a night, and if you want to,
that's very
reasonable. 50 per night, or for breakfast it's 65 for two, so you're only paying 7.50 each for breakfast.
Okay, which is very reasonable.
Yeah, and they also have you can put one child in those rooms, and they have family rooms again for not a whole lot more. So
and as you say, plenty to do and see around the area if you wanted to get out and about and explore.
Yeah, I think even for kids they have like a Wild West kind of play centre, and
we're seeing the Wild Atlantic Way, which is just
incredible, the islands all around there, and Mayo is kind of one of the most sparsely populated counties in Ireland, so you really kind of feel like you're getting away from it all. And
it is stunning in that part of the country, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, and the Wild Atlantic Way has really kind of brought the area to life.
Yeah.
Whoever thought of that, it's only been there 5 years ago. I hope they got a good payout for it, because it worked. You know, many of these tourist ideas are a bit gimmicky, but the Wild Atlantic Way is ingenious, and they didn't have to build anything.
And this is very family friendly, Tom.
Exactly. Well, I mean, yeah, it is. It's like I say, the kids can kind of go, if you've active kids, there's like plenty to do in the area, and Westport has a great kind of like food scene and kind of family.
And the hotel looks fabulous.
Yeah, yeah. It's lovely.
So let's move on to 4-star then.
Okay, 4-star, we're kind of picking it up a notch. I guess to get value, you have to go outside Dublin. Dublin is so expensive, and Waterford is an area of the country that I always find very reasonable. Mm. So Faith Lake Hotel, Faith Lake House, that's a kind of a fancy Downton Abbey-esque domain on the banks of Waterford Harbour, where the Norther Barrow and the Shore meet. And they rebranded and kind of refurbished the place last summer. I stayed there, and it's a really good sign of a hotel when you're there and you're asking yourself, is this a 4-star or a 5-star, you know?
That's a great sign.
Yeah.
So it transpired that it was a 4-star, but the rates are 108 euros per night. So 54 euros per person sharing with your breakfast, but you really get a kind of a 5-star feel of the place. It has wonderful period rooms based on all the kind of the fancy people who were living there throughout the centuries.
And a cracking golf course.
A great golf course. Here we have it. Yeah, there's Faith
It's a great it's part of the country. I had my stag down there.
Did you? In Faith Lake?
And we played three. There was a deal where you played 3 golf courses over 3 days.
Yeah.
And I can't remember. I think it could have been Faith Lake we stayed. I don't remember a lot about it, to be honest with you.
It was a bit hazy, was it?
But it's great golfing country.
Yeah, it's
stunning
gorgeous.
Down
and
there.
You've good
and Waterford
weather.
Town is a great town.
It is. Brilliant. It's got the whole like Viking vibe going on. There's Momo is a really nice restaurant there. They have the vintage parlour rooms, which do like live music events, and it's also, I guess, on the access to Ireland's ancient east, the other kind of tourism area.
Yes.
So you can, from Faith Lake, you can hop on the pontoon ferry over to Ballyhack in Wexford, and maybe, oh, here we go, yeah, go down to beautiful Hookhead, which we see now. That's one of Ireland's most popular tourist attractions now, Hookhead, and
that's all the peninsula we're seeing
tours.
Now, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really stunning.
And you know what? It's with the new motorway as well now, straight down to Waterford. It's what, an hour and a half? Is
no
it
time.
I came up there a while ago, and it was, you really fly up.
And you can get yourself a blah.
Get yourself a blah and see a few baths with all the sheep in the Comoro Mountains too, which are really stunning. The Magic Road, where you put the handbrake on the off the car and it goes up the hill. You know that one? Have you heard of that
I've never heard of that one.
Yeah, it's worth the trip. That's not too far from Waterford City itself. It's a bit farther.
Not that we're suggesting anybody goes and does that today. No,
yeah. But the city's a great night spot as well.
It's an amazing city.
So, yeah, plenty to see there for
now,
sure.
Now, five-star. Anna, where are we going for five-star?
We're going to Killarney.
Oh. Killarney, yeah. I love Killarney. A lot of... Yeah. Do you guys like Killarney?
Some people think
it's a bit too touristy.
No, it's love great.
But I feel there's always something very cathartic about driving into the west and you just... All the McGillicuddy reeks kind of just ascend before you and it's just... It's magical. And so when I was looking for a five-star, I picked Muckross because I feel... Muckross Park Hotel. I feel it's one of the more affordable five-star options in Ireland, and I've stayed there, and it's really, as of you,
I have.
It's really, it's my favourite hotel in Kerry for sure. It's kind of, I would say, call it quite like classical and kind of luxury conservative vibe. But rooms start at €135 a night. So that's £67.50 per person sharing. And with that you get your breakfast. Now the breakfast is, I mean, that's a meal in itself. Yeah. They do an outstanding breakfast where you have like
an award-winning breakfast.
A smorgasbord of kind of foods. Then you order your hot breakfast and they have, you know, kind of the tiers of all the scones and pastries and it really feel well looked after. I think customer service too in Kerry is, I mean, Ireland, we've got good customer service anyway, I think, or at least friendly, but it's at American levels down there.
Yeah, because Killarney is built for it.
Yeah,
absolutely.
They know it's their lifeblood,
exactly.
But the welcome you get in Killarney.
And there's so much to do. There are incredible restaurants in Killarney.
There's scores of restaurants. I think the Port House is one I really like, but there's loads to choose from, and they really know how to plumb off you and treat you well, and you've so much to do in Killarney too. From an outdoors point of view, you can go kayaking on Loch Leanne or go into Killarney National Park.
National Park is amazing, and again, great golf and country down there as well.
Spot some red deer and
so for that money it's not hugely expensive, and you will really feel like you've been treated.
No, for a real treat.
Yeah, 65 euros each isn't too bad. I mean, for a five-star.
For what
you're
getting.
You can go into like the 200s and the 300s, particularly in Dublin when you're talking five-star
hotels.
But I think 135 is a really good deal when you consider you're getting definitely 40 quids worth of breakfast
easily.
And you've got the spa and access to all the kind of...
And there's a beautiful spa there, actually.
There is, the gorgeous kind of Roman
style. So what other travel tips do you have for us ahead of the Easter break, Tom?
I guess just in terms of hotels, obviously, I mean, it's always more flexible if you can venture off midweek, if you're not like a big partier and you don't really need the weekend vibe. But for booking hotels, I always compare sites with the hotel itself and something like hotels.com.
Often you
find shop around. And one thing with hotels.com, just sign up, get a through your Facebook and get an account. And if you gather 10 nights over a year, which sounds like a lot, but if you go on a week's holiday and a weekend, you'll get a free night stay.
Okay, it's like your coffee card.
Brilliant, great options. Loyalty. As always, Tom. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Absolutely.
Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Tom. Happy holidays.